What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Let's Play Death Road to Canada with Dog and Pony. I'm Dog and Pony, and this is, of course, Death Road to Canada. I'm calling it now. This is the video where we make it to Canada. We no longer have a full party. We could have gotten one, but I didn't want to have a non-rare character. It just didn't make sense to me, using up food and stuff. The horror continues, the ice. We are three days away? 3 days away. Keep an eye out for a sweeter car. Agreed, this one's gonna break down, but we are all mechanics at this point, so maybe that's fine. Miserable camping. The group couldn't find any safe shelters, but was able to cobble together a campsite. The weather is terrible all night. Jody's morale goes down. Valerie didn't mind it much, but her attitude is revealed as positive. And TLB thought the weather was nice. His wits are revealed as super low. Is that fair? I don't think that's fair. You can enjoy rain. Like, I guess if you're camping outdoors, it's kind of weird to enjoy rain, but you can enjoy a rainy night. The group eats a decent meal. Minus 6 food, okay. 2 driving days until Canada. So excited. Valkyrie loves this road trip. Car breakdown. The car is broken down from use and abuse. It won't start up again. You know what? Okay. TLB's strength is better than Jody's mechanical. He could punch it into, he could punch it back fixed, but it would only go like one more stop. So I think we're gonna have Jody attempt to fix it. Jody pops the hood of the car. It's easily repaired in no time. Perfect. Okay, that was better. Trading on the death road. The group is driving down a long stretch of road. No threats on the horizon, but not much else of interest either. You have 40 food left. Unexpectedly, the group finds someone they can trade with. Visit trader camp. All right, it's still raining here. As you can probably see, if you're looking, you might not be looking at the video. I don't know. Maybe you like listening to me. Maybe you are blind and that's just fine. Or like legally blind, but you can still see. You just can't tell that it's raining. Or you're busy doing some work. You're watching me to get through your work day. That'd be weird. The group meets The group meets a woman wearing oil-stained coveralls. I can help you get better at repairing stuff. It's a real handy skill. Might save your life. No. No. We're fine. We're good. We don't need it. How about those zombies? What a pain, am I right? Yeah, you're right. You got me. Mobile gun show. The group finds a man selling a bunch of firearms. He's holding a minigun that has both a scope, a laser sight, and a flashlight attached to it. However, his selection seems pretty common stuff. You have 40 food. I want to see the good stuff. The trader decides to show the group the good stuff. You have 40 food. For 40 food, we could buy a flamethrower. Or for half that, we could buy an assault rifle. Don't need it. Or for just 25, we could buy an auto shotgun. We're going to leave for now. Okay, got to do some math. I hate doing math. What are you doing? Come here. Okay. Army surplus fortress, 12 grenades for 40, Uzi for 15, assault rifle for 25. We don't need any of that. We're going to leave it alone. This guy, gas to snacks conversion, you can probably safely ignore. You have 7 gas left? Oh, goodness. And axe merchant. The group meets a strange and menacing figure. He or she is wearing a mask. And a trench coat. I sell axes, just axes. We have 40 food. We don't want any axes. I think we want to buy an auto shotgun. How much shotgun ammunition do we have? 66. Is that worth it? Yeah. Yeah, it is. Okay. So this is going to cost us 25 food. We've got 40. That means 15 would be left after this, and we've got 3 people, which means we eat 6 food per night. There's 2 nights left. We need 12 food. We'll have a surplus of 3. Auto shotgun for 25 food. The group buys an automatic shotgun. Now we're talking. You're set until you run out of shells for it. Okay. I wish he threw in some ammo with it, but we'll be okay. It's good. Let's hop in the car and get going. Okay. Nice. We're gonna be on foot in the rain, and that's really bad. Out of gas. The car is completely run out of gas and coasts to a stop car abandoned. Okay. Oh. No medical supplies. All dirty! Yeah, my favorite. While walking through the woods, Valkyrie doesn't pay attention to where she is going and falls into a deep puddle of water. Her gear is fully submerged, putting supplies in danger. We lost a lot. And her, morale's going down. It went down 2. That's pretty bad. Bear stole my stuff. The group's attempt at camping is interrupted by a very angry bear. They are forced to abandon the camp with little sleep and must make a panicked decision about what to grab. Valkyrie rushes to the bear, jumps up a good height, and then thumps it in the nose as hard as she can. The bear freaks out and runs. The group is able to go back to sleep. Jody's morale increases, Valkyrie's morale increases, and the group eats a decent meal. Perfect. Perfect result there. TLB rolls up his sleeves and starts tending to their wounds. He tries to help but lacks enough medical supplies. Okie dokie then. We need more medical supplies. The last street in the world, there's a city ahead. Rotten with zombies. The group knows that walking through a city street like this is a bad idea, but a car waits at the end of it. We got a very thick swarm. They're hunting, and it's the afternoon, but it looks like it might still be raining. We're going to walk through anyway, because it's the only option. We got an auto shotgun. And we're going to not use it, because we want to save it for harder encounters. We don't want to waste our ammo. So we should be fine with what we've got. I don't really need the nail board, obviously. But holding it doesn't hurt. We need these two here to just smash all these zombies. We don't need a lot of gas. We just need enough for like 2 or 3 more encounters. We do need food because we lost a lot of our food. Pretty much all of our food. Because of, bad. Hey, look, I can pick up cars. Hey, when did that happen, and why couldn't I do it in the last place? That's awesome. Okay. I wonder if the game was bugging, or if I can only pick up some vehicles. I don't know what the restrictions on picking cars up are, but I can do it now, and that makes me pretty happy. Looks like I can't accidentally hurt my group with them, so that's definitely helpful. Okay. Gasoline. It's probably enough gas, but since this one is right here, we're good. This is a strange looking vehicle. I don't think I've ever seen one quite like this. We're gonna hop in, hopefully get everybody in and get out of here. This is going just fine. We're up to 7 food. That's more than I thought we had. Okay, that's enough for one night, and that's pretty much what we need. The group gets frustrated because the CD player in the car is jammed, playing the same song over and over again. Who should try to repair it? Obviously, Jody. Jody removes the CD player and puzzles over how to fix it. She doesn't manage to repair it. The CD player remains broken and annoying. Everybody's morale goes down. That's fine. Okay. Whew. TLB tries to help, but lacks enough medical supplies. That keeps happening. And we're all pretty much at full health anyway. It doesn't really matter. Jody could obviously get that one more boost, a little blue health there. While driving on the death road, the group decides to make a stop for supplies. A big grocery store. We do need a little bit more food, and this usually has more than just food in it. So I think this is the right decision here. Maybe we should have just kept driving. But I'm going to say no. That's so cool. Oh, goodness. TLB is the best. TLB is the best as long as there's cars that he can pick up. And you're controlling him, because I don't think he'll do it without you controlling him. I guess if special characters could use all of their special abilities without being controlled, that would be a little overpowered. Because then you would just let them do their best and have everyone else control like a non-special character, so that you get the most out of it by forcing the player to control special characters to get the most out of them. You're adding a little bit of a level of difficulty there that still makes it fair. A level of difficulty that is better than the all dirty and like, oops, I stepped in a puddle and it was 8 feet deep encounter. That one's annoying. That one, just the ones that make you lose a huge portion of your supplies, I don't think those are necessarily, I don't want to say fair, because there's a certain connotation to saying the phrase not fair. But people think, like, well, life's not fair. It's like, yeah, but games kind of are supposed to be. If not, okay, balanced. It's not balanced. Does that sound better? There's a difference between fairness and being balanced. Something can be totally unfair, but be a perfectly balanced thing. Can I carry the car inside? No. I want a few more zombies to come out, and then I want to crush them with the car. Like that. This is so cool. Oh, I wish I knew about this sooner. Who knows how well some previous runs would have gone if I knew about this? I don't think there was ever a situation where we had, like, TLB and everything would have been perfectly fine if we had just known about the cars. But I think there were some situations where, had we known he could, like, lift and throw things, and had we known the full benefits of lifting and throwing things in general, regardless of if it's TLB or not, we might have been able to save another character and thereby extend our run. I don't know. We might have one more traitor camp. I think that last one was the last one, but in the event there, you know, in the case that it wasn't, and we do have one more, we want to get as much food as we can, and because we're perfectly safe here, essentially, we're killing most of the zombies pretty easily, so I don't think we're in danger. We want to loot as much as possible, and we want to get as many medical supplies as we can, because we are out of those. And not just running short, we are completely out. We haven't found any yet. I thought maybe we picked one up since we got to the grocery store, but that is not the case. It's a large grocery store. They had a lot of employees, and for liability purposes, they had to have had first aid kits around. But that doesn't mean the game is going to necessarily agree with me. Toilets. For the genie? No genie, unfortunately. Yeah. Toilet genies are dangerous, but not as dangerous if you remember to actually take a reward from them. I wonder if they're always bad, though? Like, do you think some toilet genies are nice and some are evil? Because we can ask the question, you're one of those evil genies, aren't you? And then he just leaves and fills the room with zombies. And it's like, why would I ever choose that option more than once if there was only a bad outcome from it? Is there also a good outcome? Or is it just like, hey, don't choose this? Hey, buddies, what are you doing? There we go. You're not lost anymore. You're not stuck on that toilet. You're fine. That was weird. The AI is better. I think in the last video I said that I was really mad at it. It is better, it's just not quite where it... I think there's gonna be more updates, more fixes to it. Like, hey, don't walk into a wall for 2 minutes because you don't know what you're doing and then die. There's one more room to explore here, maybe with some medical supplies. It looks like it's mostly just food. That's fine too. We might get an opportunity to trade those for medical supplies. And I think we are gonna go ahead and leave. I think that's everything. I want to check all the way to the right at the entrance again. Sometimes there's stuff buried in there. All right, we're good. Let's get out of here. That may have been overkill to kill that one zombie, but I enjoyed it, so whatever. Let's get out of here. And are we about to rest for the night? I don't really remember what's happened prior to that grocery store. We got 37 food. That's amazing. Sure go for anything else right now. Cabin with wood stove. The group finds a cabin in the woods with no zombies in sight. It has a wood stove in it, but no wood. We're just going to go to sleep. We're safe here. It's fine. We were one driving day away from Canada. I don't know how long this is going to take, but I'm going to stick with this video until we lose or we win. So even if it goes into like the 40-minute mark, and I don't think it will, we're going to stick with it. The group finds a trashed house with some bottles and tattered rags searching. It seems like a waste of time, but Valkyrie has an idea. They could take the bottles with them and to throw at the zombies. We're just going to leave the house. We don't really have any room in our trunk, and Molotovs are pretty dangerous. There's no real purpose to having them, especially if it's going to like waste time or space. Last shot before Canada. I was right. I guess I was, like, wrong, but then also kind of right. An enormous army of undead shambles around the carnage that surrounds the border to Canada. It's quite a sentence. Many have tried to get through. Most only succeed in having their bodies added to the horde. Maybe your team will be different. This is the last chance to trade. Good luck. You have 31 food left. All right. Whew. We're at the end game. We're here. We are in a pretty decent position as far as weapons go. We got a fitness trainer. We're gonna leave. Let's see who else we got here. We don't want to waste our food if there's something really good here. We're not gonna be able to afford a minigun, unfortunately. We got strength training. Don't need that either. But we can declare a pose off. Oh, I like doing this one. Let's leave for now. And then we're gonna turn this man into stone. I love that he's wearing a beret. I don't think I've ever seen him wearing a beret before. I feel like he should have a sweatband on and not a beret. All right, this is just someone healing us up. Medical attention. The group finds a woman surrounded by medical equipment. She claims to be a skilled doctor. She offers to provide health care in exchange for food. You have 31 food left. We're going to leave for now. Jody needs to be healed up, but we'll probably do that. Let's turn this guy into stone real quick. All right, strength trainer. It's an old but fit man in matching gray sweatpants and sweatshirt. He screams something about building mass in bulk with an intense strength routine. He flails towards some heavy objects lying around. You have 31 food left. TLB declares a pose off. TLB flexes once using only half effort, but the contest is already decided. Impossible! This is impossible! Shrieks the strength trainer in a strangely high-pitched voice. I'm not gonna do that. Are you the swole that was promised? And then he turns into stone and moments later shatters into a million fragments. TLB's morale increases. Okay. I forgot that that would increase his morale, or I just didn't know it to begin with. That's interesting. Sure. How much food do we have? I wish he, like, exploded into loot or something. Just exploded into bullets, because that's how strong that guy was. We've got way more than enough food, so we're gonna switch to Jody and heal up. We'll have 25 left, and we don't need even that much, let alone more than that. So give 6 for treatment. Who should get the treatment? Didn't need to switch to Jody, because we can just select it here. Jody gets treatment for her wounds. Okay. Why would anybody else get the treatment? I don't know. That's a good question. Viewer that probably didn't ask that. We're going to hop in the car and get going toward the border here. All right. I'm pumped. I think we can finally do this. Have we ever made it past the first layer of sieges? I think so, because we know that there's a second layer, so therefore we must have at some point gotten to that second layer. Giant armies of undead perpetually lurch around the Canadian border, unable to cross. The group gets caught up in a lesser swarm before they can find a safe camp. Siege alert, there's no escape. Overwhelming afternoon, 1.5 hours. Seek shelter in cabin. Valkyrie, you don't need a piece of wood. I'm sorry to tell you that, but you just don't need it. We've got a spoon that we also don't need. It's a spatula. I always think they're spoons. I don't know why. Should she have something else? Should one of them get the auto shotgun? I don't see why not. Okay, I do see why not. So here's the thing. We can either guarantee we win this by taking the auto shotgun, or have a decent chance at winning this and have a better shot at getting through the next set of swarms if we don't take the auto shotgun. I think we can get through this. At least 2 of us can get through this alive. And that's all we need. I'm going to take a pipe bomb with us. And we've only got 12 gasoline. Okay. It's probably a good idea to save that for the last encounter here. I think we do need to drive a little further after this, so we're not going to bring the chainsaw. Hopefully we'll find some gas and use it next time. We need to be fighting, and I'll say either. I threw the pipe bomb. Hopefully that takes out a couple zombies. It did. It took out like 3 or 4 of them. And we need to cut through here. I want to get into the cabin, of course. Hopefully they can make it. Yeah, they're good. We got more food. Gasoline is perfect. Chainsaw is awesome. Having 2 chainsaws is pretty great. I'm going to throw this at the door there and get everyone away from it. Okay, now that we have more gasoline, I want to switch to Jody. Yeah. Okay. And pick it up. You broke the chainsaw. That sucks. We're switching back to TLB here. And I think I want to stick in this bathroom. And I have a reason for it. I'm going to kill the zombies that are in here. And I want them to... I want to start taking them out, like choking them through this door if possible. Them breaking in kind of ruins this plan. But I think we're going to be fine. I don't know why you're using a piece of wood, you idiot. You have a hatchet. Why would you swing a piece of wood? Is it because it's lighter weight? It must be because it has like a lighter weight, so she'd use that over the hatchet. But come on. All right, we're still doing pretty much fine here. The siege is over, you cannot try to escape. There's a little bit more pistol ammo. I don't think we're gonna be able to get to it. We gotta sneak around up at the top. I wanna pick up this hatchet. Okay, you know what? I think Jody dropped her hatchet when I picked up the chainsaw as her. Guys, get away from the pipe bomb. Okay, awesome. Now I can go pick up this ammo. Get a little bit more food or some gas. That's fine too. We got a nail board or a sledgehammer. Okay, Jody picked up the nail board. I'll go pick up the sledgehammer. I can't use it. I wish I could throw anything I'm holding. That would make it a little easier to control TLB if he could throw anything he could pick up. Yes, let's hit the road. Okay, we got one more chainsaw in the car. Hopefully it's better than the last one was. I think she might not have been holding any gas, so she swung the chainsaw and it broke. Glimmer of hope on the death road. Ooh, okay, the group feels inspired after managing to survive that situation. They feel like they are getting the hang of this. Choose a reward for the group. Valkyrie, I don't know if her fitness can improve above the best, but why would we give her 2 when she's already at full? Anyway, we're probably going to do morale and random skill gain. Yeah, I think that's the best option. Strength would be lost on 2 of us. Medical, we don't have any medical supplies. We got 1 medical supply. I'm going to go morale and random skill gain. Every day is a great teacher as long as you don't get eaten. Jody's morale increases. Valkyrie's morale increases. Jody's strength increases. And Valkyrie's shooting increases. That's great. I guess it tried to increase TLB's strength or something that was already full. So we're just going to keep going and eat that lack of a gain in skill. It could have been his attitude. It could have been his strength. It could have been fitness. Maybe even loyalty. Who knows? Let's just keep driving. We're almost to the end here. I can smell it. I'm going to take a quick drink of Canada here. Sorry, I was reading that sentence. I'm going to take a quick drink of coffee here. Last rest before Canada. I was in my head halfway through that sentence when I started talking out loud about coffee. The group prepares for the brutal day ahead of them. Canada is close, but the zombie forecast is bad. The group eats a decent meal. There's food left for the group to eat a second meal. Valkyrie's morale increases. Jody feels pumped for tomorrow. Jody's dexterity increases. I don't know what dexterity does. Valkyrie is excited about Canada. Valkyrie's dexterity increases. TLB is ready to splat some zombies. TLB's dexterity increases. What is dexterity? In relation to what the other stats are? I have no idea. Does it like show up now? No. I was thinking maybe they got an additional trait listed in their thing, but they don't. I don't know what dexterity does. I wish right now it would just reveal everything about all of our characters. That'd be helpful during the last encounter. All right. City of Crushed Hopes. Nearly at the border to Canada, the group is surrounded by seemingly endless undead. To survive, they must face one last siege. This is the final siege, but not the last battle. Siege alert, there's no escape. Overwhelming. Afternoon, 4 hours. All or nothing. I think what that means is we have one more siege, which is a timed encounter, and our last thing is going to be a running encounter, like the sewers or the weird factory thing or the tunnel of cars, where we have to just get through a crowd to a designated point and then we win. All right, Valkyrie can have her nail, or Jody can have her nail board if she really wants it that bad. TLB can't make any use of the sledgehammer, but he also can't make any use of the auto shotgun. Okay, here we go. It's on the delete spot, but we're gonna take it away from the delete spot and give it to Valkyrie. Jody's got better shooting than Valkyrie, right? So Jody gets it. Come on. What's happening here? Okay. Nope. I'm nervous. Okay. I don't want to accidentally throw away the auto shotgun. Oh, come on. This system is so gosh darn confusing. Okay, nail... Can I stack these? Yes. Okay. That makes things a little easier. Auto shotgun. There we go. Okay. Okay. We're good. We're good. Let's do this. That was the wrong button. Let's do this. What's up with the music? This is not siege music. This is walking along the road music. Also, this is easy. I hope it doesn't get too much harder, because I'm actually enjoying this siege here. Come on, Valkyrie. What are you doing? Where'd your hammer go? Let's get back outside. Valkyrie, what's wrong with you? Leaving your hammer. Hey, TLB, I'm controlling you again. Because he's so useless on his own, he won't pick anything up on his own. As far as I've been able to find. How long do we have to survive? Is it just an hour or is it longer? Let's get out of here. Throw the pipe bomb. Everybody run. Okay. That opened up a good path for us. Took out a good chunk of zombies. There's so much loot here. Let's get away from the pipe bomb again. Guys! Okay. Okay, I think they avoided it. Okay, this isn't as leisurely as it started, but it's pretty darn easy compared to what I was expecting. Should I... Okay. Everybody please keep shooting. We're gonna need more ammo, of course. I think we're pretty much safe at this point. It's almost over. We gotta get back outside. I think it's almost over. I could be wrong. I hope I'm not. I'm gonna throw this. Guys, get away from it. Okay. So far, so good. Let's keep it going. All these pipe bombs are definitely helpful. Everybody's out of danger at the moment. Come on, it has to be almost over. It's gotta be ending, like right now. There's no way this is still happening. I'm gonna throw one more pipe bomb, because that's all we have. There's probably more loot we could get. I am really banking on this ending now. I don't know what to do if it doesn't. Come on. Okay, that's fine. Keep shooting. Oh, come on, we're cornered. We're surrounded. We're out of the corner. We're good. Okay, it's actually a little bit safer now. Medical supplies we're gonna need. I'm gonna pick up this and walk out. I think that should be relatively safe. All right. There's more zombies down below. Kinda stuck. I wanna keep them stuck. How much longer is this siege? Is there a timer? Like, time remaining in the siege? No. That'd be nice to see. I think we're out of shotgun ammo, which is... Never mind. Come on. It's not done yet? How long is this thing? Was it 2 hours? What time did it start? Oh my goodness. This is still like the farthest we've ever made it. Even if we don't make it through this, we've never made it this far into this siege. How long can this siege possibly be? It's over. Nope, it's not over. I saw the word siege disappear. I guess it just does that. Just blinks. Come on. any second. It can't last much longer than this. That's impossible. It's been like 3 hours now. Okay, she is out of shotgun ammo because she's using her pistol now. She'd have no reason to use the pistol if not for being out of shotgun ammo. Please end at 5 o'clock. We're stuck in this corner. I made a mistake. Please end at 5. Okay, we're good. Get out of here. Yes, let's hit the road. We're fine. We got 2 more medical supplies. We should be able to heal up a little bit. Nobody's that hurt. TLB rolls up his sleeves and starts tending to their wounds. We lost 2 medical supplies and treat some wounds. He runs low on medical supplies. Okay, Jody got healed. Which is fine. The end of the death road. Never made it this far. The border to Canada is just north of here. The group must cross the bridge and then reach the fort that serves as a checkpoint right outside of Canada. This is the final challenge. Good luck. It's a sardine-packed swarm and they're mega cheesed. The border to Canada is just north of here. The group must cross the bridge and then reach the fort that serves as a checkpoint right outside of Canada. This is the final challenge. Good luck. Okay. Sorry for bumping the mic there. Had a itch on my face. It's still there. I gotta scratch it more. Okay. Okay. You can make it. Do we have it? We have no ammunition, do we? Okay. There is enough pistol ammo to fill the pistol once, and shotgun ammo, just a little bit. Valkyrie's got 11 ammo in this thing, and she'll get a rifle as well. There's no reason not to give that to her. Chainsaw. Yeah. It's got 38 gas. Probably better than whatever I just put away. It didn't go in the same... I have no idea what just happened. Okay. And TLB... We'll give him the 2 smoke bombs for no reason whatsoever. Maybe those will be what saves us, and Giles's sacrifice won't be for nothing. Okay. Whoa, that was weird. Hey, TLB, pick up this car and just throw it. He's listening to... They added voice commands into the game. They didn't. That was a stupid joke. I apologize. It probably would have passed my joke test when I'm making the No Money Monday videos, because they're mildly scripted. I have a chance to come up with material ahead of time and then say it, you know, in a more scripted capacity. And I don't have to... You know what? I'm just going to bring a van. I'm going to bring this. Yeah, this is going well. TLB is OP in this situation. And my test on jokes... Oops. TLB disappeared after throwing the smoke bomb. That's interesting. And he got hurt because of it, too. So, probably bringing the smoke bombs wasn't a good idea. Because I don't really know how they work. But this van is kind of our savior right now. And we can't bring it anymore. That's unfortunate. It won't fit through the debris. Maybe we could get a smaller car and bring it through the debris. Anyway, so my test for whether or not I should make a joke in the NMM videos is I'll tell the joke to X-Arm, and if she rolls her eyes, I do it. It's snowy. It's snowy. There's so many zombies! All we need to do is get one person there, right? And that one person is going to be TLB because it's who I'm already controlling. I don't care if anybody else makes it. I don't care at all. Someone died. Who cares? It's boot time. Squirp. Face off. Can we... What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? Do we have to kill them all? Okay, so I made a mistake. I made a mistake. I made a mistake. Valkyrie is still alive. Everyone is dead. Valkyrie is alone. Valkyrie is fine. Something just happened. Let me take care of them. Oh my god, Canada robot. I knew the Canada robot would save me. I've always known it. Oh, Canada. Etzer Beam. We could talk to this guy. Where's your skidoo? I don't have a skidoo. Blue skidoo. We can too. I'm Bud the Spud from the bright red mud. And I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go up into Canada. Who's this guy? Victory over the death road. You've got a can-do attitude, eh? Congrats on making it to Canada. The Prime Minister himself makes Jody an honorary citizen of Canada. He welcomes her to the last remaining nation on Earth. Okay, Jody, you just died, but you're an honorary citizen of Canada. Onward to Canada. Rare characters mode completed. Total zombie kills 2177. Death Road to Canada, a game by RocketCat Games and Mad Garden. So this is Canada, eh? Guess I made it alone. It's a bit brisk. If I had known about that final fight, TLB would have made it too. And maybe Jody, because I might not have sacrificed her so readily if I knew there was more to it than just sprinting to the end. Wait, what? What? There are no penguins in Canada? But ice, snowing, penguins. Sigh. Keep Awe. Oh, Kepa. Oh, these are names. Kepa Awe, Paul Pridham, GP Lackey, and Kanzate, Camilo Arturo, Joey Grady. Great. That's everyone that made the game. I see penguins. More penguins. Sigh. Thank you for playing Death Road to Canada. Try a different gameplay mode. Okay. I can do that. I finally made it to Canada. We finally made it to Canada. That is all for now, but thank you for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, and I sure hope you did, I sure did, make sure to click that like button. Subscribe if that's the sort of thing that you're into, and share it with your friends. Maybe share the video where we started this one? In a few days, I don't want to spoil anything for anyone, so in a few days, I'll probably tweet like, hey, start watching the series at episode, I don't know, what is it, 74? For some good stuff. I'll see you in the next episode.